In this video, you're going to find out two things. First, we are going to turn this model into the Illustrator file, so you can have 3D into 2D. I also like to show you how am I getting this 3D from the vector file that I found it online. Are you ready? Let's get started. Let's start from Rhino to Illustrator first. You can open any of the files that you have done as a practice. I have done this ring before and I want to turn it into a 2D graphic for my laser cut. I'm going to find the best angle that I can find to see what is the best to represent this drawing. And I'm going to select everything. Using the command is leaving under the dimension and then you have make 2D. In this window, we want to pick up the view that we have right now in the perspective, and we do not want to have a hidden line or tangent. We want to make sure the drawing is clean. And then it will create a new layer name. It's called Make 2D. And then you will click OK. After that, you see there's a drawing on the top. Usually you will look on the top view to see the more accurate. Sometimes there will be some line missing, for example, right here, and we can actually manually to create some sort of an illusion, like starting from this point, coming here and coming here, for example. So that will look like a prong has the edge there. So you will go back to fix some area and some extra line, for example, like this. You want to ungroup it and you want to delete the line. You don't need it. And for example, right here, you might want to add it back. So you may need some editing for completing the drawing. Notice that this is the angle of what I was looking at in the perspective. If you're in the perspective was not in this angle, it will come out different result. Let's go back to the top view. Once I have done this, all I need to do to transfer to Illustrator is going to select everything and we are going to type export. Right here that you have a choice, most likely is preset for whatever Rhino version that you have, either on the Rhino 6 or Rhino 5. We want to choose Adobe Illustrator and we want to give it a name. I happen to have one here. I'm just going to name it the same. It's called Ring and I'm going to save. It will ask you a few things. If you want a laser cut exactly the same, make sure that you reserve the model scale 1 millimeter to 1 millimeter. Otherwise, it will be really different. And then if you don't really care about that, you just go to snapshot of current view. Let's stay with 1 millimeter to 1 millimeter and let's click OK. All right, then we'll go to Illustrator file. We're going to open that ring file over there. And then it will come up something like this. And we want to go ahead to zoom in bigger. You can use this file for the laser cut. Make sure you change the color according to your laser cut. If you want to change the stroke, you can go ahead to, you know, make it fatter or make it thinner. It's up to you and depends on what you wanted to do with this graphic. Let's take a look on how I getting from Illustrator into this 3D coin looking form. So the website that I use is called Freepik and I was typing animal head vector and it will come up a lot of a choice right here. I will suggest you to pick something black and white so it's clean and it's easier to extrude it. And I was picking this one. Make sure that you credit to the website or credit to the author. When you click download, you can download it for free, but you also need to copy this and put it on your website as you can see on my description. So once it's done, finish the download, you're going to see an AI file there. Just double click. Then you will see this. We actually only need the line work. First, we need to unlock all the layer. Second, I would like to delete anything that we don't need it here. And then we get those block over here. We're going to save us again. And I'm going to save as a head, as my name. and click OK. All right, so now we are at the Rhino. The first things we wanted to do is call import. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go into import and we're gonna pick up the head and we click open. Ideally, we wanted to have a boundaries because we just need a curve, but sometimes they're coming into the hatch. And yes, they don't have boundary. We only have those hatch here, and it's actually not gonna work for us. So we're gonna use the command called duplicate border, and we're gonna pick up everything's here. And now we have this curve right there. Okay, so I am going to copy this curve on the side just for you to see the progress, and I'm going to group them. And also gonna draw a circle roughly bigger than the curve, the horse that we have. And I'm going to use the align centers tool to align right in the centers. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look on the perspective. Now we have those curves, I'm going to extrude them separately. The first one, it's going to be extruded straight on one side for 4 millimeter, and then I also want to give in a fillet for maybe one on each side, so nice round point. The second one is this group curve, I'm going to move it up for 2 and extrude it straight and cover the entire area or over the surface on that point, and then we are going to pulling difference this out of this one. So that's how I moving the Illustrator file to create a 3D file. If you are the first time to my channel, I welcome you and invited you to subscribe it my channel. Please like it and comment and share my file. That really helped me on my ranking, and that's the only way I can keep making free tutorial for you. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next.